So x leaves remainder 2 with 3, 7 or 11. That therefore x has to be a multiple of 3, 7, 11. 3, 7, 11. And 2 added to it. So the smallest multiple of 3, 7, 11 would be the LCM of 3, 7, 11. With nothing common, the LCM would be 3 into 7 into 11. 21 into 11 is 231. That's the LCM. Add 2 to it. Turns out to be 233. But this is not the only number which will lead to such remainders. 231, remember, is the smallest number. Any multiple of 231, 462, will also be a multiple of 3, 7, 11, and therefore when we add 2 to it, this would also lead to the same result, that 3, 7, 11 would lead to a remainder of 2. So the value of x can be many. Infinite number of possibilities are there. So statement 1 is not sufficient. Statement 2 alone is of course not sufficient. Exactly. There are again lots of possibilities. It doesn't even say that x has to be an integer. So again, infinite number of possibilities. On combining, however, it has to be between 200 and 500. See, both these values that we got here are between 200 and 500. Of course, there will be more values. 231, the third multiple, 693 plus 2. There will be other such cases. But between 200 and 500 as well, there are two cases. And therefore, x could be 233 as well as 464. So even on combining, we don't get a unique answer. Combining also doesn't help. And therefore, E is the right answer.